3-0 was a fair reflection on today's game, the result?
To be honest, the question I didn't ask so far, if it's a fair result. In general, it's for us a disappointing result, and I totally got the feeling today it was 100% possible to be the first team in the league to beat Leeds, and yeah, they played on a top level, and you could see why they are unbeaten at the moment on the top of the table. I think at the moment 100% the best side in this league with lots of quality, and yeah, it's a sign that a player like Bamford is able to come in. They bought him for several million pounds. He was not one time used in the starting lineup. It's a side of unbelievable quality, but I got the feeling today it was possible to beat them. And yeah, for that we are disappointed.
You started very well. So were you surprised when you conceded?
Not surprised, because you know, so Leeds is each and every moment able to score a goal because of their quality. I got the same feeling. So I think the first 20 or 25 minutes was just a power play of us, and no team caused Leeds more problems than we did in this period. Yeah, the thing is, when you want to be successful on this level, then you have to use one of your chances in this period to go and lead. And otherwise, it could always happen that there is a situation where the opponent is able to score. And yeah, anyhow, out of their first situation was a counter-action. I think we were a bit too slow in our head and now in transition, and we're not in the right position. But if we're honest, yeah, the header out of 14 meters, normally there can't be a goal out of this. It was a big mistake then. And yeah, second situation, if you're really honest, wasn't even a really good chance. So they were anyhow in a position for a crossing. But anyhow, after this situation, they were neat with 2-0. And then it's difficult. So if the league leader is at halftime 2-0 up and they are full of self-confidence and they could concentrate just on defending and just to be there with counters, then it's difficult. And in the second half, I got the feeling, so 20 or 25 minutes, we put again a lot of pressure on them. We're pretty close to be there with our first goal, to be back in the game. And yeah, with their first strike in the second half, they went in lead again. So fair credit to this quality. Was a outstanding strike of, I think, Hernandez to the 3-0. And yeah, after the 3-0, the game was done.
Do you think Leeds are such a good team at this level that it's unfair to judge Norwich by this game?
No, because we play in the same league and we have to be judged because of this game. And I think, but it's for me, like, I'm a football coach and don't judge after result. So result to lose 3-0 is anyhow disappointing, but I judge after the performance, and I didn't see such a big difference just from the performance side. So we had a side who was able to use their chances, especially their first chances, and yeah, we were anyhow there. I think in general, when we judge a game till the 3-0, we had more chances, and I got the feeling, especially in the first half, even the better chances. But yeah, they played anyhow in their last row and close to the box line without mistakes. Yeah, and were able to, for example, block the last header of Tom Tribal in the first half, or blocked the shoot with an unbelievable tackle of Timo Pukki 2 times, just 6 meters to go. And they were anyhow able to use their first chances with slight mistakes of us. And I think that was the difference today. And okay, you see that there is a slight difference at the moment in the quality. But I think in general, in terms of the performance, we are not too far away. Yes, what should I tell you today? So I made it clear. So we are pretty happy that we have him. And I think for me, he's an outstanding goalkeeper. He knows right now 100% that before the first goal, he should either save the header or put the header up to the side and not in the center. It was, yeah, of course, he was involved in the second goal. Yeah, like I said, Ajoski was anyhow in a crossing situation. And anyhow, the ball was in. He knows it was a huge day for him, and that it is due to mining on this level. But yeah, I'm pretty sure he will respond. And like I said, so he has our trust, and we know that he's able to play much better. So in the last 2 games, for example, our last home game, he was outstanding. He had a really good game at Sheffield United. Yeah, perhaps not the perfect start into the season for him, but It's quite normal when you don't play each and every time on this level. You are perhaps there with a bit rusty start, and you know, a bit tough for us to take this today. But it is like it is, and we back him, and we totally trust him, and he will respond, I'm sure.
I think dressing room has received quite a lot of publicity in the days approaching this match. Is it fair to say it didn't have the desired effect?
To be honest, I'm not a believer in the color of the dressing room. So I heard it was a topic because some of our interior designers painted in pink or whatever. We had also some change in our home dressing room. The only told the lads before, the only dressing room that was not changed was my dressing room. I have to speak with the lads. So I don't believe so much in this. I don't believe if the color has an effect. So if it either put the concentration away or motivates the opponent even a bit more. We had so far pretty good home games, and you can judge after the last home game and say, yeah, it worked, or after the cup game it worked, or after the West Brom game where we scored three goals, you could say, yeah, and you know, we put the concentration away. Today you could say it can't work. So for me, it has nothing to do with the result and nothing to do with the performance. So perhaps I'm a bit old-fashioned in this topic, but that's what I think. To be honest, I'm responsible for really many situations here in Norwich, for transfers and how we play and the starting lineup, but I don't take each and every decision in this club, and which song we play before the players run out, and which color the dressing room has. And I don't know how many guys are working in the stadium and how to clean the stands or whatever. These are all questions I'm not interested in, and nothing important for me. So I can't have each and every situation. I trust the people who designed our dressing room, who designed also the dressing room of the opponents and whatever. And I think we had many changes before this season. So we changed the site where we have to warm up. We changed the songs we played and whatever. But these are all not topics for me. So my topic is playing football, and all the circumstances are not important for me.